If you like Faber's videos and maybe you want a few makeup recommendations as well, keep watching. Hey girl, welcome back to my channel. Today we're gonna be talking about my favorites for the month of May. I feel like this month was such a good makeup month. Most of the things I tried, I loved, so I'm excited to share them with you guys. First of all, if you look down, you're not subscribed, smash that subscribe button, join the family, and also make sure you give this a thumbs up if you find this video helpful. So the first product that I want to talk about, this is from the brand Clove and Halo, and it is a powder foundation. Now, Clove and Halo is an eco-friendly beauty line, and they make products as well for deeper skin tones. This is their beautiful powder foundation. Now, you can also use this to set your whole face. What I love about this is that when it goes on, it doesn't have that powdery look. Like, it's not gonna make you look cakey, you know what I mean? Because that's never cute. Like, I personally try and stay away from products like powders that make me look cakey, and I love that this one just goes on like a dream. I use my Real Techniques powder brush to just put it on, and it's gorgeous. They do have, I think, two shades that are deeper than this shade, which is my current all over face shade. Highly suggest that you check the brand out, Clove and Halo. They're based out of Atlanta. They're a small beauty company, and I really want to support brands that also cater to women of color, so definitely check out their website. Now, if I were to show you my primer collection, you'd be appalled at how many primers I have, but I have a few go-tos. And I really love this new CoverGirl Skin Smoothing Primer that they came out with as part of their like summer collection. And I also got this with the foundation kit that I showed you that came in PR. This is so nice. It really does, like, those areas where you have like pores or any texture, it really does a great job of smoothing without feeling too heavy or drying your skin out. I don't like having my skin look super pasty and dry before I put on foundation. So this is really, really great. Also affordable, great drugstore pick. So if you are a drugstore diva, girl, you gotta check out some CoverGirl products. Now, keeping it in the CoverGirl family, the new True Blend Matte Made Foundation is everything you've ever wanted in life. If you love a matte foundation, girl, it's bomb. If you haven't seen my review, I'm just gonna tell you in short, I love this foundation. This is what I have on right now. It completely matches my body, which is so hard because I usually have to bring my foundation down to my neck anyway and my chest area. I'm just like, look at it. And when you touch it, I mean, there's nothing on there. It's transfer resistant, which is a dream because now that I live in the Northeast, like, it gets humid. I just want a matte foundation that's not gonna transfer on any of my clothes or make me look like a mess when I start sweating. You know what I mean? So if you like kind of that light to medium finish, I think you're really, really going to like this foundation. It's been giving me life so far. So I have two eyeshadows that's been just my favorites for the past month/month and a half. The first one, this is the Urban Decay Beach Palette, and this came out recently, and you guys, this is perfect for summer. If it's got like a little bit for everybody. If you like bronzy/pinky, you're gonna love these colors. And then when you wanna get a little bit sassy, a little bit colorful, you're gonna go for the blues, and this brown is just gorgeous. I use all of these colors with a wet brush, and it gives me the best pigmentation. It just always looks so nice. Like, I wanna live in these colors all summer long. I think it's beautiful. I love the formula. You guys have heard me talk about this so much, so I'm sorry if it's annoying to you. But I think it's a really, really good eyeshadow palette. I love the design of this. You don't really see palettes flipping out like this. Cute little mirror here. You can fold it back. You know what I mean? It's great for travel. Now, let's switch it up. We gotta talk about setting powders. I have a lot of different setting powders, and I all use them for like specific reasons. I'm you know, I'm a little bit of a makeup hoarder, so I've got my own reasoning for things. Now, the Milani setting powder, this is in the color Translucent Medium to Deep 02. I love this powder for setting the areas where I've put my concealer. One of the reasons why I love this is because it goes on and it has that smooth finish. It doesn't look cakey. And I use a dome-shaped fluffy setting brush to apply it. And I really like, you can close it. You know, as you can see here, it's got that little twisty thing where you can close it up if you're traveling and, you know, you just don't want it all over the place. And it's just, it's bomb. I love an affordable, loose setting powder. I mean, what's not to love about that? Everybody wants to look cute on a budget. You know what I mean? Now, another one of my favorite collections that came out recently was the Makeup Shayla and ColourPop collection. Now, these two are my favorites. Let's start with this one, the Perception palette. Now, you guys have seen me do a couple videos with this palette already. First of all, the design is bomb. On the back, you've got all the names, and on the front, it's just a really great selection of colors that you're actually going to use. And yeah, I won't go too much into detail. You can definitely check out my review on her collection if you're interested, but it just, every color I've tried just looks great. I can't complain, and the price is right for this. So if you get the chance to get this before it completely sells out, I highly recommend that you do. ColourPop is just, they're killing the game. And that next product is the highlighters. The highlighters don't look like they're gonna be all that great, especially when you look at swatches online, you know, they just kind of look a little bit underwhelming, but on the face, they just look beautiful. This one, Pose, it's the loose highlighter, and it's more of a rose gold. It looks so beautiful on deeper skin tone. If you do have a lighter complexion, Boomin is the other highlight, and that's gonna look really nice. It has a champagne color, but this one is just kind of my favorite without looking too extra. It just looks nice. Like, I don't even know. It just looks like a nice sheen. Now, in the blush department, I've been using like the same blush, and this is the Patrick Star and MAC, the Take Me Home blush. This in particular is from the Miso Philique collection. Man, like, it is just so beautiful. And you know, when I first saw it, I was like, oh, that's gonna be too light on me, like, whatever, it's not even gonna look cute. I'm telling you, take your brush and just swirl it together. It's so gorgeous. It blends so nicely. I don't even know, this is just kind of like powdery crack for me. I think that it just looks beautiful with every look. So for me, it's a staple product. If you guys happen to have it available in your MAC and you are interested in the other products, because they do sell it in a set, then I definitely recommend that you check it out. These sets are definitely affordable in terms of MAC prices. But again, this blush is just, it's booming. Now, this concealer, honey, she's full coverage, okay? This is the IT Cosmetics Bye Bye Under Eye Concealer. This is the shade Deep that I have here. Now, I think for a concealer, it is expensive. To me, it's $32, just because there are some other great drugstore items out there, but this one is a full coverage concealer. If you've got deep circles under your eyes that have a lot of pigment and you really need something that's got like that bang, you know what I mean? So it'll cover it up. This is a really great concealer. Again, it's full coverage. It's got anti-aging ingredients in there. It's waterproof, and that is amazing. Like, if you ever end up in the situation where you're gonna be caught in the rain, or maybe you're gonna cry, you don't have to worry about your concealer. She's gonna stay put, you know what I mean? Now guys, I just wanted to share with you a product that I did not like at all. I did want to update you. I did a Beauty Bakery foundation review, and that foundation did not work out for me, unfortunately, because I really wanted it to. As you guys might have seen if you watched my review, it was really hard to spread out, and it didn't spread out evenly. It kind of looked splotchy in certain areas, and other areas didn't have any coverage. When I sprayed my Fix Plus to kind of like set my makeup in, you know, it looked really splotchy. You could see all the spray marks, all the watermarks in my foundation, which just infuriated me. I was like, no, after all this work, you know? So basically, I just decided that I was going to return it. It just wasn't worth it to me. Even though they were great and they sent out two shades, it just wasn't really working for me. And it did have me looking quite oily on a not hot day. It was like raining in Burlington, Vermont. So that was just kind of weird. I was like, this foundation is not right for me during the summer. I know some of you guys had really great experiences with it, but it was a total flop for me. Now, if you haven't checked out these videos right next to me, you definitely want to watch them because I'm going to be spilling the tea on what I think about them and how they perform. As always, thank you guys so much for hanging out with me. Subscribe if you're not subscribed already, and I will see you in the next video. Bye!